The Australian survivor castaways have been on the island for 36 days now. As time ticks by, the competition gets more and more fierce. Last night, Benji pulled off the ultimate blindside against champion Matt. Let's take a look.
I think it's time. We can take out Matt.
I'm going to be like, hey, Brian, Matt's gunning for you. Hey, Monica, Matt told me to spy on you. Just to, like, paint Matt as this big, bad patriarch who's running the show and piss them off and make them angry at Maddie.
If anyone has a hidden immunity idol and you want to play it, now will be the time to do so.
I do have one I want to play, but I'm playing it for Matt.
No. Don't play it for Matt.
No?
No, play for you.
You play it the way you want to play it.
Okay, I'll play it for myself.
Matt, the tribe has spoken.
It is.
Ouch. Well, Matt Rogers joins us now live from Brisbane. Welcome, Matt.
Hello, how are you going?
Now, can you believe that was some blindside for us at home? How was that for you? Can you believe it?
Oh, yeah, I can. You know, it's sort of you sort of live by the sword, you die by it, right? I mean, if you're going to be in there and you're going to sort of have all your chips in the middle, it's... I certainly wasn't a shrinking violet in the game. So I knew they were going to come at some stage. I thought we sort of had a little bit more time, though. So I was sort of trying to preserve things till we get a little bit further down the track. But it wasn't to be, and Benji pulled off a great move.
Yeah, well, I saw your eyes dart, so you were all going, uh-oh. Was that the literal uh-oh?
You know, I was just... In the game, but like that sort of stuff happens pretty quick once the votes come out and all that sort of stuff. So when Benji sort of spoke up, I was sort of just looking at Benji thinking, what's going on here? And then I was trying to sort of calculate in my head what was happening. And like literally before I knew it, names were being read out. And I mean, to watch it from home and you're well rested and you're well fed and you're healthy is very different to sitting in tribal council, exhausted, you know, hungry, tired. You sort of don't think as clearly and as quickly on your feet as what you may when you're feeling great. But you know, it happens. It makes for a great show, and Benji did a great job and pulled off a pretty big move.
Mm. Wow.
Is he going to have a huge target on his back now, though? I would think he's very obviously shown his cards that he's able to undercut everyone. Do you think he's got a target now?
Yeah, well, I mean, the thing is, he played a move that sort of broke up our alliance, and he obviously has the other four in his back pocket now, so... You know, they've got the numbers. So, you know, my alliance is down to three and it's a bit of a concern for them. You know, it's going to be interesting to see how this thing plays out now.
What's it like being on, you know, 36 days we mentioned, literally on the ground on that island?
Yeah, it's tough. The physical aspect's probably not as tough as the emotional side, you know, when you're away from loved ones and, you know, I mean, I've got a unique situation at home with my children and... So I knew I'd left a lot on my wife's plate, and I felt sort of concerned for that throughout the whole show, and not being able to communicate and all that sort of stuff. It's tough, but you know, you just sort of got to try and shut it all out and try to be in the moment, because there's so much happening and things change day to day. So you're trying to sort of play the game, try to not get too emotional, and try to not get too caught up in situations. But it was a really fun experience, and who knows, it might come around again sometime.
Yeah. You actually had a hidden immunity doll. I bet you wish you used it.
Well,
did
I do
you take
now.
It home?
yeah, I do now. Well, it's not actually mine. It's actually Moana's, so I plan on giving it back to her. But I tell you, when you don't know it's coming, you don't know it's coming. So being blindsided, I mean, if I had information going in, I would have played my idol, you know, there's no question. But when you don't know and it's just, you're trying to think on your feet, and like I said, there was confusion around what was happening. And when Benji was smart in the moment too, because he's like, oh, it's going to be a split vote. And I'm sort of sitting there trying to calculate numbers in my head. And before I knew it, hey, there was names being read out and one of them was mine and I got sent home.
Mm. Now, you were dubbed the godfather of the Champions Tribe. What did you make of that title?
You know, it's funny because I got asked this morning about, you know, what was my biggest play. I'm like, I don't even really remember making plays. You know, we would get together as an alliance and we'd chat about what we were going to do. And then, you know, I guess I was the one that delivered information. So it looked like I was the one dictating to everybody, but it wasn't the case. We certainly spoke amongst our alliance and made decisions together. And I really couldn't think of a play that was mine. So maybe I wouldn't have won if I got to the end anyway.
Now, who would you like to see take the title of Soul Survivor this year? One of your original tribe?
I'd love to see one of my alliance win it, but it's going to be tough from here, given the numbers. But who knows how it's going to play out. I know Benji's, you know, scheming away in the background and he's, you know, pulling the strings a little bit. And he's probably pulled more strings in this game than anyone. So if he got to the end, it'd be hard not to vote for him. So we'll have to wait and see how it all goes.
Wonderful. Well, don't forget to tune in to the next episode of Australian Survivor Champions versus Contenders. That's tonight at 7:30 p.m. on 10 and Win. Matt Rogers, thank you so much for joining us.
No worries. Pleasure, guys. Thanks for having me.